Will everyone now please bow your heads? God, we want to thank you for getting us through possibly the most insane 4 years that any of us could imagine, for helping us make it through both high school and a pandemic, and for challenges both have brought us. We ask that as we take the next big step in our lives today, you continue to help us get through it, to be with us, our families, and our friends, to be with us as we go into our future lives. Amen.
Please remain standing for the national anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Good afternoon. I am Dr. Bart Miller, the proud principal of Cleveland High School, and it is my privilege to welcome you to the 2022 graduation ceremony of Cleveland High School. I want to extend a special welcome and thank you to the parents and relatives of each graduate. At this time, I would like to introduce our guests. Guests, please stand as I call your name. Mr. Stephen McCandless, Superintendent of Cleveland ISD. Mrs. Maria Silva, Executive Director of Special Program and Learning. Mrs. Karen Billingsley, Chief Financial Officer. Mrs. Sandy Williamson, Executive Director of Human Resources. Dr. Christy Dietrich, Director of Secondary Curriculum. Now our Board of Education, President, Mr. Willie Carter. Vice President, Mrs. Kelly Jenkel-Axton. Secretary, Mrs. Amanda Brooks. Members, Mr. Robert Howell. Mr. Marvin Searles. And Mr. Chris Wood. And now the Cleveland High School faculty, Associate Principals, Ms. Erica Lewis. Mr. Mark Rodriguez. Assistant Principals, Ms. Heather Barrett. Dr. Tyra Hodge. Mr. Langston Patterson. Mr. Johnny Paz. Mr. Scott Sims. And Mr. Aaron Van Way. Our counselors, Mrs. Tiffany Griffin, Mrs. Pamela Horace, Mrs. Stefania Langley, Mrs. Taylor Sayre, Mrs. Catherine Snyder, Mrs. Jamie Youngblood, College and Career Counselor, Ms. Sky Howell. Presenting the class of 2022, Ms. Sylvia Franco, Mr. Francisco Garcia, Ms. Kayla Mahan, Mrs. Christina Marino, and Ms. Daisy Quezada. The tassel turner for the class of 2022 is Dr. Christy Dietrich. At this time, would you please welcome Catherine Paz, the historian address.
Good afternoon. As some of you may know, I'm relatively new to the district. I wish I could say that I was able to witness the changes that the town has seen the years before I arrived, but unfortunately, I can't. Although my time here has been short, I've made lots of great memories, and I'm proud to say that I've been a part of something amazing. When I moved to Cleveland during my junior year, I remember there were only a handful of us in my algebra class before it started filling up. This is where I met Bayan, who's now one of my closest friends. I'm not gonna lie, I thought she was super annoying when I first met her. The only reason we became friends was because we drove the same car. Sorry. After some time, I eventually came around to loving her, and here we are almost 2 years later. If you came to school face-to-face, I think we can all agree that the first couple of weeks were pretty great. The hallways were pretty much empty thanks to COVID, and I could walk without having someone step on the back of my shoe every stride I took. As COVID restrictions lessened, the hallways and classrooms started becoming more crowded, and the true number of students started to show. The next thing I knew, I was walking to my classes shoulder to shoulder with the people next to me, with half my shoe off because the people behind me never failed to step on them. This was definitely an interesting experience for me, since the original graduating class in my charter school was only about 100 students. So speaking here to a class of almost 500 only a couple years later is surreal. One of my friends mentioned something that I hadn't thought of before. They said that having this jump up in population that Cleveland has been experiencing for the last 5 years is a good thing for the community, and I completely agree. It's providing the town with diversity that it probably wouldn't have gotten had it not been for all the land that was being sold in the terrenos. With the majority of the people moving in being Hispanic, the town was exposed to new cultures that closely mirror the population of the greater Houston area. Many of the people that have come to Cleveland have different ways of seeing and doing things. And if you've met my dad, then you know firsthand of what I'm talking about. The sudden influx of students and their families from different school districts and different backgrounds will be crucial in our preparation to properly coexist as future professionals and leaders in today's world. Before I walk off the stage and become a part of Cleveland's history, I want to thank everyone that helped me to get where I am today. Dear Mom, thank you for supporting me no matter what. Even when I give you lots of random, uncalled for attitude, you never fail to stop loving me. I know that you think that after today I'm gonna act like I'm grown up, but the truth is that I will probably be calling you from my dorm in the middle of a mental breakdown asking if I can come back home. Dear Dad, thank you for always pushing me to my limit. Not only in school, but in every aspect of my life. You never let me do less than what you believe I can do. And to my brother, Johnny, thank you for becoming one of my best friends. As much as we fight, you're the closest person to me on the planet. I enjoyed our 40-minute rides to school every morning, and you always came through when I passed you the aux cord. And to all the people I met when I moved to Cleveland, thank you for the memories. I might have only been here for 2 years, but Cleveland has been pivotal in my educational career and in my personal life. I will always be thankful for all the experiences I was afforded in this town, and I can't help but be excited and optimistic about what the future holds for us and the upcoming generations. This not-so-small town will forever have a special place in my heart. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Cleveland Independent School District would like to recognize our top 10 graduates. These students received a gold stole and cord to be worn during the graduation ceremony. Students, if you are in the top 10%, please stand and be recognized at this time. You may be seated. It is with my pleasure that I present to you the historian of class 2022 with that wonderful speech, Ms. Catherine Paz. She's graduating with a grade point average of 4.4915. She will be attending the University of Houston. Catherine has received a total of $6,950 of scholarship funds. It is with honor that I present to you the salutatorian of class 2022, Mr. Kerry Wood. Kerry is graduating with the grade point average of 4.5935. He will be attending University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley. Kerry has received a total in scholarships, $48,750. Our valedictorian of class 2022 is Mr. Mustafa Musum. Mustafa is graduating with a grade point average of 4.7695. He will also attend University of Houston. He has received a total of $14,750 in scholarships. And now, please welcome Kerry Wood with the salutatorian address.
First off, I'd like to thank Catherine for her speech and everything. That was great. Thank you for coming. My name is Kerry Wood. As y'all can probably tell, I'm a graduating senior at Cleveland High School. I know that not everyone here knows me or knows about me, but I've lived in Cleveland my entire life. I was lucky enough to witness firsthand the changes that Cleveland has gone through the past 18 years. And looking back, it really has been a wild ride during our 4 years in high school. From the unprecedented growth to the changes in administration to the COVID lockdown, we as students really have been through a lot. It's been a struggle, and regardless of what has happened through those years, we should be pretty proud of what we've accomplished. We were able to power through some pretty tough situations, and now we're moving on to the next steps of our lives. All of us are about to head out and follow a myriad of different paths, some off to college, others trade school, and some straight into the workforce. No matter where you go or what you do, all I can say is follow your heart. I know it sounds super cliche and all, but it's truly good advice. Find what makes you happy and stick to it. Because just think how fast these past 4 years flew by. Time really is a funny thing. Sometimes a full day can go by without you realizing it, and other times just a short moment can feel like hours. For example, Mr. Liggins' class. In all seriousness though, time really doesn't make sense, so cherish it whenever you can. I want to close this speech out with this. Don't let the good times pass without you realizing it. Live life to the fullest and appreciate everything that everything and everyone that got you to where you are. Thank you to all the teachers and coaches who have helped me along the way. Special thanks to Schweitz, Coach T, Mr. Jacobs, Ms. Shack, Coach Grubb, and Coach Warrens. Good luck to everyone and have a good day.
Cleveland High School would like to recognize the class of 2022's valedictorian, Mustafa Musum. Mustafa was unable to join us today and has asked if Ms. Carla Marquez would read his valedictorian address.
Hello. My time in high school has been a journey of growth, as it has for the rest of you. In ninth grade, I was told I was rank one student of my class. I was surprised, but I've always regretted being told. My mom wept tears of joy. I was taught at a young age not to accept praise, and being told I had done something great hurt me more than it helped me. In 10th grade, dual credit classes became available, and we all enhanced our thinking from being in a college environment. Some thought it was easy and some thought it was hard. I was repelled. This wasn't because the academic work that entails from dual credit classes, but because it was one step closer to growing up. A college environment felt more mature than the childlike innocence I've always tried to retain. In the 11th grade, I struggled. I decided to go online because of COVID. I didn't know the cons that would come with online classes compared to in-person classes. It seems like something we always wish for. Being able to stay home instead of going to the building seemed like a dream come true. But it was really painful. My sadness and loneliness grew. My grades dipped. I had to spend the last half of the year attending as many after-school tutorials as I could in order to reach the grades I determined satisfactory. I don't regret it. I learned more than I ever learned before in this time. Mr. Seiler, who was the teacher I spent most of the time with in these stressful times, guided me and became sort of a mentor for me. He reassured me that the hard work I was putting in would pay off, and it was a precedent for what is required for a successful future. Also, his advocacy for philosophy was one that left me pondering. However, in the past few months, I've grown a love for the field and plan to major in it. In my senior year, I felt the lowest I've ever felt in my life. A steady rising tide of pressure and trauma throughout my life had finally overflown. This was to the point where I needed some extra help to deal with the issues I was struggling with. During this time, I met the kindest people I've ever encountered in my life. The terrible, unfair life circumstances these people went through that placed them in this situation they were in made me more appreciative of my life. A woman named Cindy is the kindest soul I've ever met. She has encountered some of the most unfortunate things I had ever heard of, yet she really doesn't have one single bad bone in her body. I can swear to that. She was very uplifting and told me that she loved my name, that it was reminiscent of a king, that it's like I'm above all. I wish to echo her kindness in everything I do to the best of my ability. Thank you, Cindy. I also want to say thank you to Carrie and Hazel. You both got me out of my home where I felt very alone. Even though Jack in the Box had some of the worst food I've ever had, when we would go every Wednesday, I was really happy. Thank you, Ms. Marquez, for introducing me to your love of Stephen King books. I'm trying to collect as many as I can now. Also, thank you for being so kind that you became my favorite staff member at Cleveland High School. To me, you're an example of perfection. Thank you to Ms. Howe and Ms. Baxby for taking care of me so well and providing a safe environment for me. I tried my best, and you both accommodated me when my best wasn't enough for what I wanted. Thank you, Ms. Allen, for the goodie bags and for being so funny while I was doing boring schoolwork. In conclusion, I would like to offer some advice to you all. Try to think of others before you think of yourself. Everyone's a soldier in their own war. Thank you for listening. With love, Mustafa Musan.
Mr. McCandless, members of the Cleveland ISD Board of Trustees and honored guests, as principal of Cleveland High School, I certify that these candidates have satisfied all the graduation requirements set forth by the state of Texas. It is my privilege to certify them ready for graduation. I present to you the class of 2022.
Thank you. Dulce María Espíritu. Wendy Shalane Page. Colby Ashton Butler. Eruviel Arredondo.
Joel Omar Amador Cruz. Arlene Yesenia Blandon Mazagliegos. Nakisha Roshana Brooks. Norman Darrell Buggage. Carmel Jashawn Bush. Diana Calderon. Christian Beckham Calles Rivera. Javier Camacho Jr. Jose Ignacio Camacho. Jose Oscar Camadena Jr. Wade Alex Campbell. Carmen Campos. Clarissa Campos. Ricky Jemray Cannon.
Susana Desiderio. Diana Ulises. Alexi Garcia. Maria Noelle Garcia Leon. Jenny Nayeli Garcia Leon. Lynette Cheyenne Garcia Leon. Emmanuel Esai Garcia Oviedo. Caleb Alayer Garcia Trejo. Andres Garcia Suarez. Natalie Garcia. Sorry, Garza. Lance Matthew Gaskins. Anthony Renee Gibson. Alyssa Nemae Gil. Michael Gomez Jr. Stephanie Gomez Chavez. Yesenia Gomez Reyes. Edwin Daniel Gonzalez. Vanessa Gonzaga. Madeline Bonilla Gonzalez. Aaron Gonzalez. Anthony Christopher Gonzalez. Christian Gonzalez. Joseph Gonzalez. Josue Angel Gonzalez. Casey Joanna Gonzalez. Perla Ruby Gonzalez. In loving memory of Rebecca Gonzalez. Susana Edith Gonzalez. Shaylin Gonzalez. Benjamin Wesley Ray Gower. Edmondson Granados Castillo. Elisa Granados Lopez. Luis Angel Grimaldo. Areli Fernanda Guardado Alvarez. Fernando Vaxil Delantin. Tamaris Gutierrez. Victor Alexander Gutierrez. Leonel Alexander Gutierrez Avellano. Jonathan Alexander Guzman. Milagro de Jesus Guzman. Matthew D. Harris. Xavier Isaiah Harris. Johnny Tyrone Harris Hines III. Adriana Hernandez. Crystal Hernandez. Edith Lisbeth Hernandez. Juan Jose Hernandez. Luis Alberto Hernandez. Madison Barbara Hernandez. Zulema Hernandez. Valerie Azanet Hernandez. Tatiana Hernandez. Caleb Abraham Hernandez Nieto. Blanca Maria Hernandez Xavier. Noe Leonel Hernandez Xavier.
You need to step back until your graduate.
Bobby Herrera. Skyla Lorraine Horn. Elena Diane Howard. Lila Renee Taylor Hughes. Brenda Gavina Pena. Dalton Ray Inglis. Joshua Islas Perez. Joshua Jamon, excuse me, Jamon Jack Jr. Christian Edwin Jimenez. Ashley Mariah Kirkland. Brady Allen Cruzan. Jessica Isabel Lagunas. Oscar Yahir Lara. Lydia Ann Leal Candelas. Luz Elena Ledesma. Ronald Stephen Lewis. Karen Sheree Lopez. Jacob Preston Lloyd. Alexis Lopez. Alyssa Rose Lopez. Brianna Lopez. Bridget Lopez. Hanya Lopez. Luis Fernando Lopez. Brittany Carolina Lopez Lopez. Miguel Angel Lorado. Rumi Lozano. Jessica Luna. Julissa Luna. Yair Tereo Luna. Naya Sari Luna Hernandez. Daisy Malalao. Matthew Lee Mander Jr. Carlos Martinez Jr. Daniel Martinez. Eric Roger Martinez. Esteban Martinez. Jared Martinez. Joel Martinez. Lily Ebenia Martinez.
Paola Denise Martinez. Victoria Ann Martinez. Martínez Cruz. Cecilia Mendoza. Eduardo Mercado Jr. Charles Wayne Merritt.
Lisbeth Pérez.
Posada Rodriguez. Thomas Wayne Puggett. Carlos Brandon Quintana. Carly Quintana. Ashley Jacqueline Cristiano. Alan Yair Ramirez.
Luz Alicia Sandoval.
Eduardo Santana Sáenz. Areli Santiago Villa. Jesse Santibanez. Shane Allen Scher. Brock Daniel Sager. Josie Marie Sager. Hayden Alejandro Serrano. Alexandro Serrano. Larissa Dawn Shiflett. Sydney Jordan Sohas. Brindley Ann Smith. David Esteve Soto. Edwin Jasir Soto. Jasmine Janet Sosa.
Good afternoon. Can you please stand for the prayer? Dear Father, I ask you to please send down your blessings for these graduates today, for you to guide these young men and women as they step out on the road that lies ahead. As they commence with their lives, may they grow ever more grateful and wise. I ask you to help the class of 2022 on their new beginnings and watch over them as they accomplish their goals. In Jesus' name, amen. Querido Padre, le pido que envíe sus bendiciones para estos graduados hoy, para que usted guíe a estos hombres y mujeres a medida que avancen en el camino que les espera. Le pido que ayude a la clase de 2022 en sus nuevos comienzos y que los cuide mientras logren sus metas. Te damos gracias por tus virtudes, por tu fortaleza diaria y por su amor por los demás. Amén.
Thank you, sir, for that benediction. And I don't know how I can follow the seniors with what they were saying, but I'll do my best. I, as superintendent of schools of the Cleveland Independent School District, do declare this senior class as having met all of the requirements and are hereby the graduates of 2022. Students, please stand at this time for the alma mater. Faculty and guests, I present to you the Cleveland High School class of 2022. Congratulations, seniors.